I'm Muraleedharan CK, working as a director of photography in Indian cinema for the last, I don't know how many years. I know Nasir probably for the last 15, 20 years, probably, since he was a kid, probably. So he used to be my gaffer at some point on a film. And from there, it's amazing the way he has grown over the years. When I look at him now, I'm proud, you know, like, I mean, he's such a guy who has become, like, he has become the owner of an international chain. I can't believe it. Like, you know, I remember him as a kid who used to be on my set in 2000, I think, year 2000, when I used to do a film, he was there with me as a big support, actually. So that was the beginning of a very small company which he started in Bombay, and which became an international chain today. And I was lucky to be part of that growth at certain points, not throughout, but in between. Like, I mean, whenever you think about light, whether you need any kind of shoot, the first thing which used to come to me was speak to Nasir, you know, like, that is the way we used to be. And I was part of an organization called Cinematographers Combined. I have been, like, even today, even whenever we have a program, like, I mean, where anything which you want to run, not shoot, like, but even for other programs, like, I mean, the first number which we dial is Nasir. Like, I mean, tell Nasir we need these things, you know, or, like, I mean, come on the set and tell us, like, what all you can do about it. The growth of professionalism in Bombay industry, that's what I would put it in one word, one line, actually. Because before that, one has always been worried about the kind of stuff which used to come on the set. When I go for a shoot, when I speak to the lighting unit, the stuff which comes, half the stuff are useless probably, half the things don't work, and you're worried about how to make things work, and then you're running around, you're finding half your work is not on creativity, that trying to create a scene. More than that, you're doing problem solving, how to do things, which kind of changed over a period with the entry of lightnlight. And more than it is, I would say it is Nasir's vision of how that company would be. There are enough companies came and left. I mean, I have worked with many companies which disappeared from the market at this point. You know, I don't even know where they have gone. They all came with promises saying that, like, we will deliver this. But he's one guy who kept with his promise and delivered what he promised. And that was the amazing thing about Nasir. The difference between the lighting companies probably, the difference between Nasir's company and other companies probably is that he came through the ladder. He knew exactly what is happening on a set. He was a gaffer before, so he knew exactly what are the problems which a DP faces in a shoot, or even a lightman faces in a shoot. So that made a lot of difference. So along with a vision of bringing professionalism into the industry, along with that, he understood the problems which is associated with shooting in general. So I don't have to explain Nasir ki, like, this is what I am facing, because he knows it. I don't have to explain to him. I am not explaining to him as the owner of a company. I am explaining to him as a technician who understands what my issues are. That made a huge difference. That made a huge difference in the relationship between the lightman and the boss, probably, between the lightman and the DOP. It made a difference because he understands both of them clearly. So the way the unit grew up, the way the unit started functioning, was from that basis that he understands the issues on a set very clearly. So I can call up Nasir at any point and say, this is my issue probably, this is what I am looking at, this is the kind of set which I have, how am I going to do that? So he would understand, which no other light unit owner would understand what I am saying. So that made a huge difference. So when whenever I meet him, he will tell me, say, I was in US last month looking at equipments, and I brought these things. I brought the international type of sockets into that. He told me one day, like, see, this is the color, the yellow color, I selected it because I wanted it to be seen on a set. And instead of black cables, I want these yellow cables to be there. So you know where the cables are. You know, you are not missing, you suddenly won't find them on screen. So you know where they are. So there are these minor details which he put his head into and solved them. I have shot a lot abroad in London and all that, in Europe in general. So you find the way of discipline. There is a kind of discipline which they follow. The truck which comes with probably four people, but they deliver everything. They are there throughout. You don't have to ask them for things. There are not people running around looking for things. That was a huge difference. On a set, most of the time, even today on Indian sets, what you find is like people looking around, running around, looking for things. That changed a lot with this unit. They know where the stuff is lying there. There's a truck which is parked outside. Even if you haven't asked for something, or if you fall short of something, I know that he will support me. So this is a huge confidence which I am putting on a lighting company, which they delivered. That's why I keep working with them. When I am on a set, I can think peacefully. I can think about what I want to create. What is the image which I am looking for? Here you have a guy, I call a gaffer 3 days before on a huge set. I have lit up sets which are very huge. So there, my lighting time is around 3 days. So I would sit with him a week before and I tell him, this is my scheme. So you tell me what is that I can use here probably. Or when my working of these are the kind of things which I want, I can discuss with them and say, do you have anything else to suggest on this? Earlier, whenever I call a lighting unit, they come with those black switchboards and, you know, plug it into that. Most of the time, half of them don't have those plugs. Even if there's nothing happening on this frame, in the frame, the shoot environment is very eventful. So this was an aspect, safety, which I wanted, always hope that somebody would look into that. And when Nasir started getting stuff from abroad, like which is all, you know, made like that, designed like that for, you know, thinking about this aspect in mind. That's why I said earlier about yellow cables and things like that. So that's what he brought in. He brought in things which are absolutely safe, which are tried and tested stuff from abroad, like, I mean, they use it there with all these aspects into consideration. So that's what they brought in. So that was one huge change which I saw in the lighting industry with light and light entry. Coming to the logistics part of it, like, it is getting the international standards onto Indian screen and Indian working space. That's what a company like this is known for, and that's what I love about the company. So getting whether it is trolley boards which are, you know, equipped with that kind of stuff, with surety about safety and standards, and cables coming up of that, and tying up with company like ARI with the equipment which are of international standard, or anything which is advanced, anything which I have read on American Cinematographer magazine would be there on my set within a month's time. Or he will call me up and say, like, this is what I am ordering for. I am ordering for so many. That was the interesting part of it. It is just one or two. Like, he will call up and say, I am ordering 50, 100 of these units. So the logistics is something which now has got out of my mind. I'm not worried about, like, how many lighting units I'll have to call up, or the production has to call up to get so many lights on my set probably, if I'm lighting up a huge set, which I'm not worried about anymore. There's one point contact, I know that it's delivered. Yeah, it's amazing the way the company has grown, not just in India. There are so many centers in India and Middle East, and even I've heard that in Europe also it's coming going now. So this is an amazing growth for an Indian company. I'm really proud of that. Like, I mean, and a company which I know has grown so big. And the positive aspects of it is, number one is like the development which is globally, or the changes which are happening globally on a working space is going to come to India also the faster, actually, because they are used to that. Like, I mean, a company which is providing in that space of the globe and this side, when it is the same company, you can expect the same standards, and the changes which happen globally or internationally, I'm going to witness that soon on an Indian scale, which is the very positive thing which I'm expecting. Apart from television and internet, and which gave access to Indian audience of a global workspace, this also has changed a huge difference. Like, I mean, you are seeing on the same screen, you know, on the same theater, you are seeing Hollywood and Bollywood at the same time probably. This is what is happening with the equipment industry now. Whatever which is there, you are comparing with that. Now you can't say, like, I didn't have that equipment, you know, they had that equipment, that's why they created that. No, you have that here, you have everything here today. And that changes a lot of things in our working environment, in our space where we try to create images, which helps a lot in that sense. Yeah, it's a very long journey when you say that, from Johnny Gaddar to Mohajidaro. It's a very long journey, it's a very big journey. From I think that was a 3 crore film, Johnny Gaddar, which we tried to make it in, I don't know how we made it. It was a very small budget film which went through a lot of hurdles in the making of it. From there, 150 crore film like Mohenjo-daro. So it's a big journey. It's a very long journey, which is like, I mean, for all of us who were part of that, whether it is me or whether it is lightnlight or even other people, my assistants who had been there, I have assistants who worked from there till here, you know, like, I mean, still working with me, who have, it's a team, like I wouldn't even call them assistants, they are my associates. So it is, it's for all of us, it's a big journey, which we have progressed a lot in our journey. We have learned a lot in our journey. And along with that, we had partners like Nasir, like, I mean, who have grown probably beyond that, in that sense, you know, like, in which, in literal sense, they grew globally. Like, I mean, when I say Mohenjo-daro is probably a global film, so which is, I would equate that to some company like lightnlight.